And welcome to our WXII 12-minute debate. It is part of our 2012 commitment coverage. And today we're going to take a look at the House race in Alamance County. This is District 63, a seat that is currently held by Alice Boardson. And I'd like to introduce you to the candidates who are running. To my left is Steve Ross. He's a member of the Burlington City Council. He is a Republican candidate. He's also an investment advisor. And to my right is the Democratic candidate. This is Patty Phillips. She is a member of the City Council of Mebane. Mm-hmm. She's also a retired attorney.
That's right.
Appreciate both of you being here today. I want to start off with jobs because everyone we talk to, and I'm sure everyone you hear from, talks about jobs as the most important issue this year. We're trying to point out the differences between the candidates. I want to ask you, starting with you, Ms. Phillips, what is it, if elected, you would do to bring jobs to Alamance County and North Carolina?
I think it's very important that we work hard to keep jobs that are started in North Carolina in North Carolina. Keep these jobs locally. We don't need to be shipping them off to other countries or other states. We've worked in Mebane very closely in private partnerships, private-public partnerships with developers. This worked very well to attract businesses, and it's it helped expand our tax base as well as it providing a lot of new jobs for individuals.
All right. Mr. Ross, what would you do to bring jobs to both Alamance County as well as North Carolina?
Well, in order to bring jobs, the first thing you have to do is you have to create an environment, a business-friendly environment. What we've tried to do in Burlington is we have taken an approach of looking at where we were strong and trying to improve on that, to create an infrastructure where we could create or where we could bring in industry or new jobs into the area. Some of the things that we did, we boosted the investment in our airport because we knew that our industrial park was close to the airport. We felt like that would help. Another thing that we did is we created a certified, state-certified site that was successful and just recently, within the last month, bringing in the Sheets Corporation into Burlington. But beyond that, you've got to create an environment that is friendly to business. We've got to get regulations under control. I think we have to look at what the tax policy is for businesses, and I think we need to move ahead and really look hard at laying the groundwork for business in North Carolina.
I think that's where I want to pick up the conversation. You are in favor of eliminating the corporate tax in North Carolina. If you were to do that, where would you make up the difference from that tax?
Well, I don't know that you can totally eliminate the corporate tax, but I think the corporate tax can certainly be reduced. The corporate tax rate we have in North Carolina is one of the highest in the Southeast. Now, that's why we have jobs going to Virginia and South Carolina and other places. That's a lot like was said in the debate last night. When you create jobs, you create revenue. People start to pay taxes, you create additional revenue. When that happens, then you begin to replenish the revenues that have been destroyed by the economic conditions we're in now.
But right now, if you were to be elected, you would not have that broadening of the base yet. You would have to go in there, and if you're lowering things such as the corporate tax, we're asking, because I think voters want to know, your party is talking about consumption taxes. What kind of consumption taxes would you favor raising?
Well, consumption taxes are, and this is another word for user fees, and I think that if you look at what has taken place in North Carolina over the past number of decades, we've gravitated away from a manufacturing base, which produced a lot of capital that obviously produced revenue into the tax system. What we have to do going forward is we have to replace that loss of revenue with some form of user fees or some form of consumption tax. It could be any, there are studies going on now. It could be a number of different things. I think everything probably would be on the table.
Okay, let's go to that table. Ms. Phillips, the Republican candidate here is talking about eliminating or lowering the corporate tax rate, which would thereby increase taxes for average citizens, user fees, consumption taxes, sales tax. Do you favor something like that, or do you have some other plan?
Well, I think that we could help generate revenue by closing some of the tax loopholes. And I spoke with you earlier about that, and you challenged me on what loopholes we might want to close. In the past legislative session, House Bill 619 offered a $50,000 tax exemption on the first $50,000 earned by small businesses. Mm-hmm. But instead of limiting that to small businesses, it applied to everybody. And that could have generated over $32 million in revenue, which could have preserved jobs and allowed access to courts and a lot of other things that have had to be cut. because of the loss of revenue. I do think that expanding the tax base is a very important thing to do, and I know that in Mebane we've been successful doing that by having infrastructure in place. We have sites ready. The North Carolina Industrial Center is one of the most successful small business sites in the state, not just Alamance County, and it's because we have invested in water and sewer infrastructures and have those sites ready to develop.
Okay. The Republicans are talking about lowering income taxes as well as the corporate tax. Your party has talked about the need for education spending and therefore possibility of bringing back the sales tax as a way of spending for education. What are your thoughts on that?
Well, I think that everybody would like to avoid any kind of tax increase. That's just the way it is. Nobody wants to pay more. I think that a sales tax could be a more equitable way to distribute that. Property owners do have a high tax burden. I know that in Burlington, for instance, it's 58 cents for $100 of valuation. In Mebane, it's only 47 cents. We've managed to keep the property taxes low. But we also have a nice stream of revenue from retail that's happened with the introduction of the Tanger outlets that's benefited our entire county. So sales tax is one way to go about it, but I would rather explore avenues of stopping the hemorrhaging for tax loopholes first.
But you're willing, though, if need be, to raise the sales tax to help education?
Education is my number one priority, and if that's what we need to do, that's what we need to do. I don't think that it's responsible to promise not to raise taxes because we don't know what the future brings.
Mr. Ross, what do you say to that? Your party has not been very forgiving about bringing that tax back. Would you, when it comes down to it, there's got to be some compromise or not on this kind of an issue?
I think they're going to have to be compromises on all of the issues that come before the legislature. We can no longer take this position where we just choose sides and no one is flexible. I mean, that's what's wrong with government now. Mm-hmm. You know, everybody gets in their corner, divides up and says, you know, it's my way or no way. That's got to change. I do want to correct one thing. The tax rate is 58 cents in Burlington, and true, it is 47 cents in Mebane. But in trying to compare the tax rate, you've got to understand Burlington is the only full service city in Alamance County. Mebane is not. Well, for example, we have a full-time fire department.
Okay.
We have over 125 firefighters. Mebane has a part-time fire department and volunteers. Now, I'm not saying that that's not adequate. It probably is for a city the size of Mebane. But you can't compare tax rates. It's not apples to apples.
You want to respond to that, Ms. Phillips?
It's not apples to apples, but I do think that we have been very successful in providing the services our citizens need to have at a more equitable tax rate. And our fire department is second to none.
All right. Let me change gears here a little bit. Recently, the Department of Justice has come down, putting the Sheriff's Department in Alamance County under fire. This is involving the stopping of Hispanics, and the Department of Justice is claiming this is an illegal action. The Sheriff's Department and the county leaders have taken the position that they are not going to work with the Department of Justice. They're going to challenge this. I wanted to get your reaction, and I'll start with you, Mr. Ross. What is your reaction to what is going on in Alamance County and the decision of how to handle this Department of Justice investigation?
Well, I would have to say that the news of what was taking place was a surprise. The timing was a surprise. I'm not sure what went on in the Sheriff's Department. That's something I don't have any control over. I'm sure from what I understand, there is some sort of a defense being prepared. And I think it's premature to comment on that until all the facts are in.
What I'm asking is, do you agree with the county's position of not working with the Department of Justice, but rather challenging their findings?
Well, I think working with them and challenging their findings are two different things.
Exactly. I'm asking you, which one do you support?
Obviously, I think they should work. I think law enforcement should always work with the Department of Justice. But if their facts are right, I think they should challenge their facts.
Okay. Ms. Phillips, what's your reaction to what's happened in Alamance County?
I agree with Mr. Ross. I think that if there had been a more collaborative interface between the Department of Justice and the Sheriff's Department from the very beginning, and all of the facts had been disclosed from both parties, there would have been a better resolution to this. And I'm not crazy about Alamance County tax dollars being paid to defend a lawsuit. I don't think that that's a very wise use of tax dollars, so I hope that they are able to come to some sort of a solution without resorting to that.
This could be very costly. And Mr. Ross, would you support paying for that kind of a legal defense for the county?
Well, again, I'm not a county commissioner, they're going to have a tough decision.
Yeah.
If the facts bear out that that what took place is not as the Department of Justice has indicated, then I think it's the duty of the county to defend the sheriff.
Okay, fair enough. At this point, I'm going to allow the contestants to ask each other a question. I'll start with you, Mr. Ross. What would you like to ask your opponent, Ms. Phillips?
Well, I've just as an example, I'm someone who believes in common sense government. We've worked hard in Burlington to try to operate as efficiently as we can, and as I'm sure you have in Mebane. But there are a number of different issues that voters out here have a lot of questions about, and one of those is on the issue of voter identification. Now, I support some form of voter identification. I don't know if it would be a picture ID or some form of identification for voting, and I'd like to know what your position is on that.
Ms. Phillips?
I think that a lot of the efforts towards voter identification fraud, voter identification laws, have really been about voter suppression. And I don't think that there have been large numbers of exhibited or proven cases of fraud at the voting booth. I think that if we are prohibiting people from exercising their constitutional right, that that's a big problem.
You have an opportunity to ask Mr. Ross a question as well.
Okay.
Before you do, did you want to follow up on what Ms. Phillips had to respond?
Well, I'm not sure. I think what she said was that she is opposed to a voter identification
system. That's what I heard.
System. Okay. I just wanted to clarify.
Okay. Good enough. You have a question for Mr. Ross?
I do. The last couple of years' budget at the North Carolina General Assembly has done some serious damage to public education. And my question for you is, if you had been at the General Assembly, would you have supported the budget that was passed?
What took place in the General Assembly was that the last legislature came into office with a $2.5 billion deficit. Now, you know, by constitution in North Carolina, we have to balance the budget.
Mm-hmm.
At the same time, federal stimulus money for education was running out. There was no money to continue the federal program or federal stimulus. In order to balance the budget, they had to make some adjustments. Now, some of those adjustments came from the community college system, but all the money went back into pre-K in the last session of the General Assembly. So the money that had to be readjusted to balance the budget on a deficit that they inherited has been readjusted and is back into the K through 12 education program.
You want to respond to that, Ms. Phillips?
I'm not sure that your facts are completely correct. I think that we've lost thousands of teacher jobs over the last 2 years, and those folks who are now drawing unemployment or sitting at home not working in the classroom would disagree with that position.
And I'll give you the final word, Mr. Ross, on that particular issue. Did you want to respond?
Well, the teachers that she's referring to are teachers that were hired with federal stimulus. And when the federal government took the stimulus away, you know, there was no money. Now, how do you pay teachers that are hired under federal stimulus when there is no money and you've got a $2.5 billion budget deficit? I mean, the numbers don't add up. You can't do it.
All right. On that, I'm going to bring us up to the final moment. We're going to have each candidate deliver a final statement. We're going to limit it to roughly 30 seconds, as they know. And we'll start with you, Ms. Phillips.
I am running for the North Carolina House because I have seen the hardships that the families in Alamance County face. My role on the Partnership for Children and the Alamance County United Way Board have allowed me to work with a lot of the agencies that help people who are in need through this economic downturn. I'm a pragmatic leader. I'm practical. I like to cooperate and work well with people, and I want to be a voice for the citizens of Alamance County.
Thank you. Mr. Ross?
Well, I'm running for the House because as a councilman and as mayor in Burlington, what I have learned over 16 years is that you can operate government more efficiently. We have antiquated tax policy in North Carolina. We have an overburdensome regulatory environment, some 15,000 regulations created over the past few years, many of those created by bureaucrats that are not even elected officials, that have stifled business in North Carolina. We made things happen in Burlington, and I feel confident that we can do the same thing in Raleigh. And I look forward to an opportunity to go to Raleigh and try to put the same efficiencies to work. Thank you.
Thank you, and that concludes our debate. Steve Ross is the Republican running for the county seat, for the state house seat, District 63 in Alamance. And Patty Phillips is the Democrat running for that same seat, currently held by Alice Bortson. We thank you for watching, and that is our 12-minute debate on WXII. Have a good one.